was super, super cheesy. I actually just edited it and I was like, all right, time to go film. So yes, we are on part five. I might be right, but I might be wrong. So do not quote me on that. Anyway, so I actually married them off screen because it was literally just a, you know, like a click and do your thing kind of thing, whatever, I don't know. And I had to make them basically hate each other because when he dies, I don't want her to be super sad for losing a friend and also for being a widow. And no, it's just not gonna work out. And also, Michaela, she was not about to have that life with him. Why does she look pink? I don't know. Anyway, maybe it's like my settings or something, but yeah, so we're gonna go kill him. I might do it in the basement. We don't exactly have a basement, but I'm sure I can just build one. Okay guys, so I built a basement and it's, sorry, I'm moving my mic. I'm moving it, okay. So basically, he's just kind of like, why are you doing this? And she's like, because I can. No, I'm kidding. Here is the moment we have all been desperately, desperately waiting for. Jeffrey's death, Jeffrey R.I.P. R.I.P. Yes. So Jeffrey is about to die. He is stanky. He does not look hot. And is he flipping us off? Okay, so she just got a phone call from the police saying, oh, Jeffrey is dead, and now she's very sad. But in reality, you know, Michaela's a vampire, so she can kind of, you know, manipulate the cops with her controlling mind powers. We're gonna pretend like she has that because that's a thing. Anyway, so she manipulated the cops and told them, oh yeah, I found him on the side of the road. Yeah, I found him just like this. And so she's sad, but we're gonna pretend like she's happy. Okay, so we're gonna go into the bathroom, you know, obviously after she finishes doing her business, and we are gonna go and tell her that, you know, hey, how much do you want? I have like $300,000. How much do you want so you can, like, you know, move out and I'll be on my separate way and you'll be on your way. I'll probably be in like Europe or something, but you know, it's cool. So like, how much do you want? And she's all like, what? She's like, what? Great, you guys. So this is a very, very important time in our let's play, and it is the moment that, you know, she changes and she will no longer be, you know, our little girl, Maddie. She won't be Maddie anymore. She's gonna be someone entirely new and someone different, and we have to change her hair color and her possibly skin color. I don't know if I'm gonna change her skin color, but you know. So yes, I'm gonna go do that, and I am going to possibly speed it up. I don't know. I still have yet to edit, but I might speed it. I hope so. I don't know. I might decide not to because it might be too long. I like to keep my let's plays like 11 minutes because I don't know. I feel like if it's like 30 minutes or like 20 minutes, you might get bored of it. So I like to keep it short and sweet and just kind of get to the point, you know? So I'm gonna go type in cast at full edit mode so I can edit her facial stuff, you know, like her face and, I don't know, if I want to change her feet size, I can do that. So yeah, let's go get into the cast and change up our girl from Maddie to a whole other chick. Let's go. Mama, come here, approach, appear. Daddy, I'm alone, 'cause this house don't feel like home.
Little unsteady. Oh, oh.
way he'll be like that part. And this is our new girl. Let me change her into her party wear. There we go. Mainly just because Michaela was all like, hey, we should go party. We should go celebrate, you know, because he's dead, right? Yeah, let's go do it. And, you know, she's going to get her extremely, extremely, extremely drunk to the point where she's passed out, basically. So that's what she's going to do. So she can kidnap her and basically bring her back to, you know, their house, the original house. And, you know, then we'll figure out something from there. I already have everything planned. But yes, isn't she so gorgeous? Obviously not right there, but yeah. Her name is Alyssa, and she is gorgeous, and I'm so obsessed with her. I'm so happy with how she turned out. I had, like, a lot of mistakes, and I was just, like, not happy with her for a little bit, and then I was like, yes, I love it! Yeah, she is gorgeous, as you guys saw, and she's really, really... her facial features, whenever she doesn't have a customized skin on, she's very weird. Anyway, she is creative, she's cheerful, she's romantic, and amuser. No, I thought I gave her the painting, wish thing or whatever. Best-selling author. Okay, that's not it. How do I change it? I know you can. Yeah, okay, here we go. Painter extraordinaire. Yes. Hit it. Yeah. So we're gonna go party like no other, and Samantha editing this, make it look like we're actually partying, because why not? Why not? Okie dokie, so we're here and we actually invited Dawn over, you know, because we were Black Widow for a little bit, you know, hanging out with Jeffrey a lot, and we didn't give a lot of time to Dawn, and Dawn has really been supportive, and we've known him since the first ever part. I'm pretty sure we met him on the first part, yeah, and he's just gonna be in her heart forever. That's like her true love, I think, but I can't speak for her, even though I kinda can, but you know, it's cool, it's whatever. So yes, we're gonna go party like no other. Remember, Samantha, make it look like we're actually partying, because that's awesome. Yes, okay, anyway. Now I'm feeling so fly, like a G6, like a G6, like a G6. Okay, so we're trying to find the bathroom right now. Samantha, you better have made it look like we were actually partying. I'm just saying, how is there no bathroom in this entire... Oh, there it is. There it is. Okay. Was very concerned for a minute. Okay, so she's gonna go to the bathroom, and she's kind of like, hey, I don't feel very good. Oh my gosh, weird glitch. Lag, whatever. I don't feel good. Can we, like, leave, you know? Because I'm, like, super tired and about to pass out, I feel. And why are you asleep? You're the one that's supposed to drag her home. Well, to your home, your ex-home, whatever we're gonna call her home. And she's like, yeah, totally, you know, you can fall asleep in the cab and I'll just make sure you get home safe, okay? Okay. Yeah, right. Okay, guys, so it is the very next day and she woke up in a place that's, one, not her home, and two, whoa, there's like a weird glare in the window. That's just weird. Okay, anyway, yeah, she woke up in a place that's obviously not her home, but I mean, at least they, you know, supplied her with like a chair and a shower and a toilet and a sink and a bed. At least they supplied her with that. Yeah, so there's like a bed and a toilet, but no mirror, which is very, very rude. You know, how are we supposed to make sure that our face looks on fleek? And she looks very concerned, and she should be. So in the next part, like I said, I already have everything planned out. It's all written down right here in my trusty handy notebook. Anyway, so in the next part, we are going to figure out why she was taken, like why they wanted her so bad, and I'm really excited to film that part. I haven't filmed it yet, obviously, but yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to rate and subscribe, and I will see all of you guys in the next video. Bye, guys. Now I'm feeling so fly, like a G6.